Suboccipital muscles are very, very important because of the relationship of the occiput to the atlas. So one of the ways that we're going to release the suboccipitals, rather than just randomly digging in the posterior occipital atlantal membrane, which is right in here, the soft spot, you never want to just be doing random work in the posterior occipital atlantal membrane. Because why? Cranial nerves, vascular, you've got the vertebral artery pumping up through there, you've got spinal nerves, so you want to stay out of that area. So what you do is the first thing you do when you're going to work suboccipitals is locate the spinous process of C2. So you go to the lowest bone on the head, which is the inion, find the lowest bone on your head, the inion, and then you drop down and you've got a hollow space. That's where the spinous process of the atlas vertebra would be if there were one. Instead, you go right below it and you will find, if you ask them to move their head around a little bit, you'll locate that spinous process of C2. C2 is the most important vertebra in the neck because of its transitional forces that connect from below and above to the cranium. And so we want to always use that as a landmark. So the first thing I do is make sure I know where I am when I'm doing suboccipital work and make sure it's not just some random deep tissue release in there. So I find C2. The places that I want to go with the C2 is, first of all, I want to go straight up a little bit to the right and to the base of the skull. I'm right there at the base of the skull and my thumb is pointing that direction toward the table. And that is what muscle? Rectus capitis posterior major. That is the major head extensor, head on neck extensor. So then I just want to come right next to it with my other thumb. And what muscle am I on now? The rectus capitis posterior minor. Now, if this rectus capitis posterior minor is tight and fibrotic, then you definitely want to get in here and do this work. Sometimes, however, it is flaccid, weak, and has no tone at all. You have to be careful because it does attach into the dural membrane, and so we want to make sure that we do not loosen it, try to release it if it's already flabby.